Oasis Audio presents The 5 Languages of Appreciation in the Workplace, Empowering Organizations by Encouraging People, by Gary D. Chapman and Paul E. White. Read for you by Dr. Paul White. This book is dedicated to our parents, Sam and Grace Chapman, and Roger and Eleanor White, who modeled hard work and perseverance throughout their lives, without always receiving much appreciation while doing so. Preface to the updated edition. In 2009, we began researching how the 5 love languages might apply to work-based relationships, focusing on appreciation as the parallel concept in the workplace. We developed the Motivating by Appreciation inventory to help gather information to help in this process. We also created a range of appreciation at work resources to assist leaders and trainers in applying the concept of authentic appreciation with their managers, supervisors, and employees. Since 2011, when the 5 Languages of Appreciation in the Workplace was originally published, the response has been exciting. We've sold over 300,000 copies of the book in English, and over 150,000 individuals have taken the online MBA inventory to identify their primary, secondary, and least valued languages of appreciation. Our book has been translated into 17 languages, and our materials have been used in at least 60 countries. We have over 700 certified facilitators of our Appreciation at Work workshop across the globe. And most importantly, the sales and reach of our book continue to grow each year, selling over 30,000 copies each year, helping leaders and employees throughout the world learn how to communicate appreciation effectively to their team members. The concept of appreciation in the workplace remains highly relevant to developing positive workplace environments, and at every level of an organization, individual employees strongly desire to be appreciated. But the workplace continues to change, and we have learned much over the past decade in understanding important factors to communicating authentic appreciation across a wide range of work settings. As a result, our goals for the updated revised version of the 5 Languages of Appreciation in the Workplace are to cite recent research related to appreciation, to share important lessons learned from the thousands of employees with whom we have worked, to provide examples from a wide range of industries, to clarify points that we feel are critical to understanding and applying the 5 languages of appreciation practically, and to connect you with the numerous resources, articles, videos, podcasts, assessment tools, training materials, and visual symbols we've created to help you build workplace cultures of appreciation. We trust this updated version will be a valuable resource to those who previously read the first edition, and also to those who are just learning about the power of communicating authentic appreciation to help workplace relationships become healthier and more positive. Warmly, Dr. Paul White and Dr. Gary Chapman. Introduction. Do you feel appreciated by the people you work with? If so, then you probably enjoy going to work each day. However, if you do not feel appreciated, then your work may simply be a means of keeping food on the table. All of us expect to get paid for the work we do. Yes, we would all like to make more money. But the number one factor in job satisfaction is not the amount of pay we receive, but whether or not we feel appreciated and valued for the work we do. A survey by the Society of Human Resource Management shows that employee recognition and engagement are key to retaining good employees. And according to research conducted by the U.S. Department of Labor, 64% of Americans who leave their jobs say they do so because they don't feel appreciated. This is true of employees across the board, from CEOs to housekeeping staff. Something deep within the human psyche cries out for appreciation. When that need is unmet, then an employee's level of engagement with their work will be low. Here are the comments of 3 employees who work in very different settings, but share a desire to feel appreciated. It's not about the money. I would not be leaving if I just knew that they valued the work I do, Dave said. Dave was a 30-year-old assistant to the CFO of a commercial real estate firm. He had been working for the firm for about 15 months and initially was excited about the opportunity the position gave him for personal and professional growth. But over time, he grew more and more disillusioned. Dave informed us he had resigned from his current accounting position and was moving to a different firm. It's not about the money. It's just that no matter what I do, how long I work, or what I accomplish, I never hear anything positive. If I make a mistake, I hear about it immediately, but if I do my job well, the silence is overwhelming. In a session we were conducting with the staff of a successful manufacturing company, Cindy laughed and said, "That'll be the day." We were discussing the results of the MBA inventory with the team. Cindy's primary language of appreciation is acts of service. Cindy, the executive assistant to the patriarch and CEO of a family-owned business, loves it when coworkers pitch in and help her get tasks done, especially when the workload is heavy. She had worked for Mr. Stevens for over 20 years and knew him as well as anyone. Even though the CEO, now in his 70s, only worked part-time, Cindy still had plenty of work to do, planning his extensive travel, managing his personal affairs, and keeping him up to date on how the business was doing. Cindy indicated in her MBA inventory results that if her colleagues or supervisor wanted to show their appreciation for her, they could help her get her work done if she was feeling overwhelmed. She said, "If Mr. Stevens lifted one finger to help me get something done, I'd fall over and die from a heart attack." She was joking, but there clearly was an edge to her response. "I love working here," Elena said. "I can't think of any other place I would rather work than for Dr. Jones." Now, don't get me wrong. Dr. Jones is demanding. He expects you to do your work well. We work hard, see a lot of patients, and we are all held accountable for getting our tasks completed with the highest level of quality care for our patients. We had heard from other sources that Dr. Jones, an optometrist, worked hard and efficiently and provided excellent care for his patients. And we had heard that medical assistants were lined up waiting to work for him. Why? Because Dr. Jones treats us so well. He's always doing things to make sure that we feel cared for. For example, once a month he orders in lunch for the staff, and we take an extra half hour for these lunches. We have a staff meeting where we discuss what's going on in the office, what's working well, and areas that are creating challenges for us. And we discuss how to make things go better. Sometimes he will share new research or new techniques in the field with us during his time as well. And at Christmas time, he gives us a paid day to go shopping and gives us a $100 gift card to use. But most of all, he's positive and encouraging to us. He frequently tells us that we're doing a good job, both individually and as a team. "You couldn't get me to go work for any other office, no matter how much you paid me." The five love languages go to work. As these real-life examples show, what makes one person feel appreciated does not necessarily make another person feel appreciated. Thus, even in companies where recognition is deemed important, efforts at expressing appreciation are often ineffective. As a result of the significant impact the five love languages has had on millions of personal relationships and the critical importance that effective communication of appreciation and encouragement has in the workplace, we are committed to providing the resources to help you apply these concepts to better understand and appreciate those with whom you work. To keep from overburdening the casual reader, but at the same time, let the more deeply interested explore this additional information, we have provided links to videos, articles, and resources which you can find in the included PDF. Let's get started by looking further at just why appreciation in the workplace is so important to the health of your employees and your business. Chapter 1: What Employees Want Most. I, Gary, was having dinner with a friend who's on staff at a large nonprofit organization. I was giving him a brief overview of the research Dr. White and I were doing with the Appreciation at Work resources we had developed. When I finished, I said, "Could I ask you a personal question about your own work?" "Certainly," he said. I continued, "On a scale of 0 to 10, how appreciated do you feel by your immediate supervisor?" "About 5, he said. I could detect a tinge of disappointment in his voice. My second question followed, "On a scale of 0 to 10, how appreciated do you feel by your coworkers?" "About an 8, he said. "How many people work closely with you?" I inquired. "2, he responded. "Do you feel equally appreciated by the two of them?" I asked. "No," he said. "One would be a 6 and the other a 9. That's why I said about an 8. Whether you are a business owner, CEO, supervisor, or a coworker, this book is designed to help you learn how to communicate appreciation in ways that are meaningful to the individuals with whom you work. One exciting lesson we have learned: anyone can make a difference in their workplace, regardless of their position. Whether supervisors, coworkers, receptionists, managers, frontline employees, or team members from other departments. Why is feeling appreciated so important in a work setting? Because each of us wants to know that what we are doing matters. Without a sense of being valued by supervisors and colleagues, workers start to feel like a machine or a commodity. If no one notices a person's commitment to doing the job well, that person's motivation tends to wane over time. Stephen Covey, author of the best-selling The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, felt so strongly about people's need for appreciation that he stated, "Next to physical survival, the greatest need of a human being is psychological survival. To be understood, to be affirmed, to be validated, to be appreciated." When individuals do not feel truly valued and appreciated, the results are predictable. Workers become discouraged, feeling there's always more to do and no one notices or cares about the contribution I make. Employees become more negative about their work with increasing grumbling, complaining, and gossiping. Tardiness, both at the beginning of the day, from breaks, and after lunch, increases, as does the rate of employees calling in sick. Team members will experience a lack of connectedness with others and with the mission of the organization, and, as a result, employee engagement ratings decline. Eventually, team members start to consider leaving the organization. They begin to search for other employment, and staff turnover increases. Why just say thanks doesn't work. Communicating appreciation to employees and colleagues sounds pretty easy and straightforward. In many ways, it is. However, we also know that for the communication of appreciation to effectively encourage the other person, several factors must be considered. First, researchers have found that attempts to communicate appreciation globally across an organization are not very effective. One employee said of his organization, "We're pretty good at showing recognition company-wide, but I don't think we do a good job of it individually."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.